Hello, my gorgeous babes, it's me, Diane Chorley. Now, as you all know, I've got a beautiful music video called Mother Said Don't Give Your Love Away, available for you to watch on YouTube as we bleed and speak at this very minute. Now, it's very important to me that whilst I release this video, I need to talk to the people behind the music video, the people what made the music video great. And I'm delighted to have on the sofa, having a chat with me, the gorgeous Darkwah Kyei-Darkwah, aka the House of Bleeding Darkwah. Do you know what I mean?
I do know what you mean.
This is my gorgeous stylist, does all the Diane styling for Diane. That's why I was so bleeding gorgeous. How's you doing, Darkwah?
Thank you.
Bleeding gorgeous. Now, what was the vibe for the video? What was you thinking?
Okay, so I just thought, when I think about you, when I think about the Duchess, I think of a super cool, kooky, eccentric woman who had loads of money at one point. and has money now.
Well, I've got a little bit stored away. Yeah, not much. Let's be honest.
A cute nest egg.
Yeah, I'm starting at the bottom. Now I've got to work my way up.
Yes, exactly.
But I'm making it.
But yeah, so I was thinking of that. You know, a quirky, chic, fun kind of Grey Gardens vibe by way of like cool and interesting style,
kind of
like
a bit trampy.
Yeah, a little bit like hodgepodge, put together, like, you know, thrown together, but in the chicest of ways.
Yeah, because I've got. I tell you what, I look at my wardrobe, and I just throw it together. I don't know where it comes from, Darkwah, but it just jumps on me, and it looks gorgeous.
You know, some people are just born with it, and you have it.
But that is your job, though, to make people look as gorgeous as me all the time. But with me, you just take it to the next level. I don't know how you do it, but you make me look like $1 million.
Well, thank you.
And you did in the video.
I mean, I loved doing that video. The song, I remember because when we started speaking about it, I was like, okay, well, send me the song because I want to hear it. I want to feel it. I want to catch a vibe. And I was like, okay. So now I'm thinking, I'm dancing around. I'm like, this just needs to be luxe. It needs to feel luxe.
Oh yeah.
But then at the same time, kind of like, I'm wearing these gorgeous pieces in what could be my broken down home, but I'm gonna make it look like it's put together. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So that's where I went. And the brands that I work with were all so good. There's a specific PR company that I worked with, Black PR, who were very, very good, very responsive. I've worked with them for years.
Should we put a little link at the bottom of the thing after this?
Yeah, let's do that.
We're going to big everyone up on this. So all the clothes and stuff, people can buy it on the link below the thing after.
Oh, I love that.
I'm never so bleeding professional.
Oh my God.
That fella.
Who
Steve
knew?
Jobs. I'm like Steve Jobs.
He's not alive though.
Well, I'm not actually Steve Jobs. I'm just like him. Okay. I'm good at computers.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying, Darkwah.
Listen, she can copy and paste our link and hyperlink it, so we're good, right?
Welcome to the 21st century, people.
Yes, honey.
Next, what do you think? I'll be travelling through the internet veins like some kind of thing. Exactly, Darkwah.
Not sure it's internet veins, but that's okay.
It could be a vein, though, couldn't it?
It could be a vein.
And the blood is the digital.
The blood is...
the digital. Let's leave it.
I'm gonna let you have that.
The blood is the digital. Lady Gaga would take it in a heartbeat.
I mean, she would. But I think Applause would have been the lead track on that because she actually said something about finding a vein. But yeah, I mean, that's fine. I'm no longer. Anyway, let's move on.
Let's not fall out about it, Darkwah. Let's not fall out about it. So you were in your room. You were thinking luxe.
Yes.
You were thinking gorgeous. You went to Black PR.
Yeah.
Who we can have a little link for.
Uh-huh.
And you said, I'm taking all your clothes. What happens? What happens? That they, all the designers send the clothes to them, do they?
Yeah. So Black PR take care of a whole load of brands. And they take care of, the reason I love working with them is because they take care of London-based designers or like Europe-based designers who don't produce like en masse, because I'm not trying to produce like bulk, like just like consumerism at its worst. You know, I want people to see, love, buy a piece, keep a piece. So everything that was in the video is something that, yes, you can buy, but it's like, it's a piece that you can wear and rewear and keep, you know.
Ooh, like an artwork.
Yes, honey. Yeah,
so you invest in it.
Yes, it's like, yes. An, and I invested in you for that video.
Oh my God. Well, I didn't get to keep any of the clothes though, so let's be clear.
You
about
didn't,
that.
But
you invested the time.
Yes, I invested the time. And are we not going to be meeting with another London-based designer to get some
Darkwah
custom
set
for you?
Up with a lovely design, and they're going to start designing the clothes.
Yeah.
Who is it?
Her name is Victoria Zuziak.
Link at the bottom.
Yeah, we will be linking.
She hasn't agreed to it yet, so
hold on. Oh, no, Victoria's agreed.
Oh.
We just need to have a meeting.
Oh, God, there you go, then. We're having a meeting. That's what I do these days. I have meetings.
Yeah.
That's what happens when you become
popular. Yeah, you have meetings and you have to schedule when you're going to eat.
Yeah.
That's what happens.
I've always got a pot noodle in the bucket, though.
Wow.
Everyone's got a hot water, Darkwah.
That's really carb heavy, though. I'm not sure about that.
What do you eat?
Me? I mean, if I'm snacking, I'll maybe have, like, some almonds and some pistachios. It sounds like such an asshole.
Is that it?
Yeah.
A couple of nuts.
Yeah, if I'm snacking, I'll have like some chorizo and almonds, pistachio nuts. Like high in protein. Maybe some dried apricots. No.
You cook the
no.
Just raw chorizo.
Yeah. Just,
and nuts.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I can't imagine. Have you ever passed a solid? We'll cut that, mate.
Oh my God.
We'll cut that,
Darkwah. No, I, you know what? Keep it in. Keep it in. Let the people know that we talk about shit while we're talking shit. Let them know.
So you have a little bit of cheese on the nuts for you?
Yeah, if I'm snacking.
Oh, if you're snacking.
Yeah, but like normally for breakfast, I'll like have maybe a green juice. So like some coconut water or coconut milk with...
But that ain't breakfast. That's a juice. That's a
no, but it's a really thick one and I drink like a liter of it. So
oh
it keeps
gosh.
Me going until like 1 p.m. and then I lunch.
You kids, honestly, the way they treat their bodies, no wonder you're so healthy and glowing.
Thank you.
Do you know what I mean though? Because you are so worried about what they put in it. Me, I'll have a Ginsters and not think twice.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That'll be my breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
I'll headbutt a Ginsters straight out the microwave on the A127.
What's a Ginsters?
It's like a little pastry, lovely little pastry with a bit of meat offal in it. You never had a Ginsters?
Is that just like a meat patty?
It's a meat patty.
Where did that name come from?
What, Ginsters?
Yeah,
where? Oh, it's a brand.
Oh.
The link below is available amongst all the designers. You'll have all the designers.
And a Ginsters.
The Ginsters link.
Yes, I want to try a Ginsters. Do they do them gluten-free?
No.
Okay.
One thing they definitely do, not do, is give them gluten-free.
Okay.
There's more gluten in that. It probably is just gluten.
Okay.
Probably just a lump of gluten.
Right,
like a massive Haribo.
I shan't be touching a Ginsters.
You won't. You
no,
won't enjoy
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
It's a tastes a bit like BO.
Oh.
It tastes like
BO. I'm not sure how I
no.
feel about it.
Enjoy it.
Well listen, we've digressed so much.
We have. Yeah, we have got to stick to it.
Yeah.
So what we should do, I think, because the video is gorgeous.
Uh-huh.
We got the video here.
Uh-huh.
We're gonna watch it.
Uh-huh.
And on the screen they're gonna see the clothes.
Yeah.
And we're gonna talk them through the looks.
Fab.
Okay.
Also to everyone who's watching, I've actually not seen the final video yet. So
it's a reveal.
If I scream at any point, I apologize.
It's
but I'm not really sorry.
They're not sorry. Darkwah is never sorry. Okay. Number
right.
one, we're opening up. Now this gorgeous little look here.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay, so the dress was yours.
That was my little dress I
had. Part of the Duchess of Canby's permanent collection.
Yeah, they're all designer goods and they're all collectible in their own right. Although
yeah.
that one did have to have a bit of gaffer tape on the sleeve. And you can probably see that if you look in the video.
No, okay, fine, whatever. I personally don't believe that you can see it. So, and if I don't believe you can see it and I styled the video, then no one can see it.
okay.
This look, so we added the Swarovski neck.
Gorgeous, that is. And what is that? Where is that?
So that's from Patrick McDowell. He is a London-based designer.
Lovely.
And he is into, he's a very sustainable designer as well. So the Swarovski crystals on there came from Swarovski because they were not being used because I think he had like a partnership with them. So he had loads of them. And he just makes these like fab little accessories that you can either like tie around your wrist as like a kind of cute little,
that looks gorgeous,
you know, nonchalant bracelet, but we decided to put it on the neck just to give it a little bit more glam.
Oh, it gave it a lift, didn't it? It looks so casual.
Yeah.
Like I've just tossed it over.
Exactly.
There, but it
exactly.
throws on £1 million.
And this is exactly what I mean by we wanted to make sure that it was luxe, but kind of just like thrown together. You know, it had to feel natural. If it didn't feel natural, I didn't want it on.
Earrings? model's own suit rider. It's true. She didn't design it, but...
Yeah.
Milky's look.
So I actually low-key am very obsessed with Milky's character.
Mm-hmm.
From the first time that we worked together, I was like, oh my god, there's so much I can do here.
Oh, and you're doing it.
Yeah. Because obviously we were talking about Milky initially as being a bit like rough and tumble, kind of like chavvy. But like he's having a glow up because he's with Diane.
Yeah, well, right? Milky don't really know what's going on. That's the problem. And what he does generally is he just puts on any old thing that he's got in the wardrobe that's been left over.
Right, and so what we're doing with Milky, what I'm doing with Milky, is making sure that everything he currently owns in the wardrobe is gone.
Oh yeah.
And only the pieces that I want him wearing
are
there.
Throw a match on it.
So that no matter what he does, he always looks glam.
Yeah.
So this tracksuit is from Edward Crutchley. And it's just... It's so fat.
Iconic on Milky.
It is an iconic look. It's an iconic look.
Edward, my gorgeous baby, if you're watching, we'll take two.
Oh my god. There's actually Edward's new collection is so you. So you.
I can feel the collab coming on.
Ah, the Duchess of Canvex, Edward Crutchley.
It's a new range.
Yes.
But isn't it gorgeous? The materials are so silky.
Yes, it is. Beautiful. It's super lightweight as well. So it was, you think that you're going to be hot in it, but you're not.
Well.
And then the Calvin Klein sunglasses that were actually given to me by my drag mother, Caramel. And I thought, let's make him Elton John if Elton John was like a scally lad. You know what I mean?
Oh god, you pulled it off. I mean, Milky is not a scally lad. You know,
no.
He's in bed by 8 o'clock. He likes a nice little episode of the Teletubbies, and he's got a little bowl of Cheerios. That's what he wants.
I hope they're Honey Nut Cheerios.
He ain't stupid, Darkwah.
I mean, I don't know. You said he has no clue what's going on.
No, he doesn't. But he likes a Honey Nut. Oh my god, this look is gorgeous, unbelievable.
I wanted to make you into a sex kitten. I'm like, listen, like. Carol Vorderman, sex symbol. Cilla Black, sex symbol.
Yeah, don't talk about Cilla, I can't. We fell out.
Okay.
Me and Cilla fell out, but she took my haircut and she went with it.
Fair enough. You know? Okay, well.
And she won the court case, but
we can bleep that out. That
bleep
name.
That.
But yeah, so when you were like, I'm going to be sitting at this mirror, I was like, right, I want her to look like she's waiting for her man to come home.
Oh, yeah.
And deliver the goods.
Oh my god,
if
yeah.
You know
getting
what I
mean. A bit saucy.
Yeah,
is what
yeah,
we're saying. Getting
yeah.
A bit...
We needed you to look, you know, ready to be ravished.
Yeah, I felt it. I certainly felt it.
So this dress, I believe, I'm just going to check my phone.
You check your bits. I'm going to have a little sip of the old...
This dress is from Isabel Mann's. From her Autumn Winter 20 collection. And it was so easy. Just like a simple like velour, I think it's velour.
I think it was. It felt gorgeous on my skin.
Don't quote me on the material, but it felt like velour.
Oh yeah.
A wrap dress, and a wrap dress is timeless. That's why Diane von Furstenberg still sells, because a wrap dress is timeless and easy.
All right,
and
Diane.
For every woman.
Yeah.
So Isabel Mann's that dress was beautiful. The color was perfect for your hair as well.
Goes gorgeously.
Right,
I love the blue.
Yes.
I do love the blue.
You do love the blue.
It's very formal for me, but it does make me pop.
Yeah.
Especially if I've got some nice beads on,
mm-hmm.
which I have there.
And then also, you don't often show, you know, the cleavage.
No, I don't like getting me bits and bobs out.
Yeah, well, they weren't out. They were just, they were pleasantly displayed.
You can have a little, you can see a little bit of the innards. There.
Yeah, what? Innards? That sounds nasty.
No, the innards of the boob.
Oh, the
cheek.
The what?
The boob. You can see the cheek of the book. Nothing too much.
I live. I'm sorry. Bub is a thing.
He's always living this one. Always living.
I live. Bub. I'm sorry. Okay, continue.
Sorry.
No.
The book.
No, so yeah, that was what I wanted to do for this look. If you're going to be sitting at a mirror and looking at yourself and feeling yourself, not that way, but feeling yourself. Then I wanted you to feel sexy and empowered and beautiful.
Well, I did. You can tell I feel it there.
Oh, yeah.
I look ever since.
Is that a cigarette holder in your hand? I don't
remember. No, it's a brush. I was doing my eyes.
Oh, okay, cool.
I was waiting for your man to be ravished.
Yeah.
I've got to look nice.
Yes.
I've got to have my eyes all right. So
put that eyeshadow on and sweat it off later, honey. That's what I say.
Oh, and I did. I tell you that. Nothing. X-rated blue movie. Gorgeous. Okay. Look at that.
Yes.
The bed.
Yes. Oh, and that was...
Oh my God.
That was... Oh my God. I pulled so much for this. That was Jacqueline Loquito. And that coat is stunning. And the slip dress underneath was from Knits. And it was just by chance that the blues matched up perfectly. And then the pink matched up with the pink on the bed.
Oh my God. You can and the blue light and the creams.
Yeah.
So luxurious.
It really was.
So classic. All of the stuff you did pull. It's funny, isn't it, that modern designers are making all this clothing that's so classic and elegant and almost like, well, it suits me so well because that's my time and my era.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Robert? You look at it here, that could be out of a 50s movie.
Well, exactly. And this is the thing. So this is the thing with styling, because I personally don't think that the brands that I pulled do classic. They do classic with like, and then turn it on its head a little bit by way of fabrication.
Absolutely.
Or by way of colorways, or by way of the fact that it's not all going to match up. There's going to be different colors on different sides.
Oh yeah.
And so I wanted to bring that air of whimsy, you know, that kind of, I'm a classic woman, but I can do new fashion.
Oh yeah.
You know? So the slip dress underneath was like completely knitted, by Knits. They're fab as well. There was so much that I pulled from them that I actually just ended up going home and like before taking it back to the PR company, I was like, do I want to take a selfie of this? And then I was like, no, we're not going to do that today.
What a shame. Knits will be devastated.
I know, but you know what? Next time.
Next time.
But yeah, so I wanted this to feel dreamy. I wanted, because it was so pure and angelic.
Yeah.
And even your makeup wasn't too,
no, it's
too
very,
much.
Well,
so.
Pippa said yesterday, we had Pippa on here. She was talking to us about the way she did the makeup. Almost quite peachy.
Yes.
She said quite peachy in the tone. She kept it very light, very smooth.
Yes.
Really matched up with the clothing. You two worked very well together.
Yeah. Considering like, we had spoken on the group.
Yeah.
On the WhatsApp group. And then we got there and I was like, okay, so these are the looks. And she was like, okay, cool. And that was it.
Oh,
this is also Patrick McDowell.
Oh, you know what? Patrick McDowell, the god.
Patrick McDowell is my babe.
Oh my God.
I absolutely love him. So this gold jacket by Patrick McDowell, I think it's so clever because it's like a bomber jacket.
Oh yeah.
But like a cape. So it looks really chic. Listen, put it on top of a gown and it's this kind of modern take on, let's say, like an old 1950s Balenciaga like cape.
It looks like you'd wear that at the Oscars, wouldn't you?
Exactly.
You know what,
right?
I mean? Yeah.
And again, we had the gold glove that we bought for the video, and gold disco pants. Did we also do gold tights or black tights?
Oh yeah, this is the thing.
This.
Oh, this is the one.
Oh my God, Milky's Yoda moment.
Oh,
I lived for that moment. I actually was so excited when I saw this happen.
You've made an icon out of Milky here. Do you know what I mean?
That's because I secretly have a crush on Milky.
Oh, a lot of people do. I don't know how or why, but they do.
Okay, so this is all Patrick McDowell.
You're kidding. We're going to have to get a sponsorship.
Everything. So it's a knit, it's a knit sleeveless turtleneck, which is oversized also. And then it's a Patrick's take on a suit, so a really beautiful like wide leg pant and an oversized suit jacket.
You can't see Milky wearing it in full, but we'll put a picture on this when we edit it so you can see him in full.
And we have him in the sunglasses again. I wanted the sunglasses to be like the recurring theme, you know. Continuity is important to
me. Because they look good. He does look good in them.
He does. So here you are in Syrah J. Yeah, you're in, I think, complete Syrah J, actually.
I mean, complete Syrah J.
Yeah.
Not the top, though, because the top's mine.
Yeah, the top is yours.
But
the skirt and the coat are Syrah J, also from Black PR. And I love the coat. I was so obsessed. I really wanted to wear it, but my shoulders are way too broad.
Yeah, mine were getting there. It's quite a Hunger Games look, I think, this one.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean? I was getting Hunger Games from this.
It's quite big boss, matronly.
Yeah. Very matronly. I'm like that woman what's on the speaker saying stuff. Is that her? Yeah, she's in charge. The scary woman.
You know, I've actually never watched Hunger Games.
Oh, I wouldn't bother.
Thank you for your honesty.
I won't waste your time on it. But I do look a bit like one of the women in that, but I love it. It's a good look.
Yeah, it's good.
She's a British designer as well?
Syra J, I believe, is based in the UK. Mm. I don't know where they're originally from.
I love all these gorgeous English designers or UK-based designers. I love that we're promoting that. Yeah. You're so good at that.
Listen, homegrown talent. That's what you have to do, right?
Hello.
Yes.
You're looking at it. We're as homegrown as it gets. bit of water, bit of...
But yeah, no, I loved that look.
Darkwah.
Yes,
Bears. Oh my God, this has been gorgeous.
Thank you for having me.
What a beautiful thing. I know you've got a lot going on, but you will promise me that you're going to stay being a stylist forever, aren't you?
But I know
you're going up in the world and you're doing all these... Got a new Bleed magazine or something that they're doing.
Yes.
You've got all sorts of stuff going on. You're always in high demand. Always working 24 hours a day. I adore you.
I love you too.
Thank you for working so hard on the video.
Thank you for having me.
Gorgeous. I adore you. I can't wait for our future working together. Ladies and gentlemen, the beautiful, the gorgeous Darkwah.